When cutting out images and removing the background, many people struggle to get good edges. There's common problems we have. You can get jaggies, blockies, halos, or helmet hair. This tutorial is going to show you how to address every single one of these by taking a comprehensive look into the select and mask inside of Photoshop. This is a two-part tutorial. This first part, we're going to look at things like hair and fur, and in the second part, we're going to dive into the rest of the tools. And make sure you watch all the way to the end because there's some really valuable information in there. Let's get started. Some people like to launch the tool first and make a selection within there. I like to make selection first because number one, it's faster, and number two, I have access to the full suite of Photoshop's tools to get that selection how I like it before I refine the edges. Let's grab the object selection tool. Now, any one of these three tools here will invoke the select subject. Now, what I'm going to do is hit the little arrow. There's two options, device and cloud. We're going to choose cloud. And now we're just going to choose select subject. Now, the AI in Photoshop is going to make the selection. So this is not a comprehensive tutorial on making selections. I have many more of those. This is a tutorial on refining the selections. Once you've made your selection, then we're going to choose select and mask. As I mentioned, some people prefer to make the selection in here, and we have access to the select subject tool up here. And you can also use, this is the same as using the selection brush. I just find it works a lot slower working in this tool. Okay, so the selection is active. We just don't see it, and that's because we need to adjust the transparency, like to turn it all the way up. Right now, we're viewing it inside the onion skin mode. Now, if we click on the view, we'll see there's different ways of viewing it. The three I use the most are on black. This enables me to see white fringes. On white, it enables me to see black fringes, such as on her skirt. And black and white gives us a clear view of the mask, so we can see what's selected and what isn't. Now, the areas that are black are 100% transparent. The areas that are white are going to be 100% opaque, or the areas we keep. Now, when you see areas of gray, those areas of gray are going to be semi-transparent. Now, of course, there's other options such as the overlay here where we can view it against different colors. Now, here's just a quick tip. If you know what kind of background you're putting behind this, you can save yourself a lot of work. You can see that dark fringe around there. You wouldn't have to worry about that if you were going onto a dark background. Notice I've got the white fringing around the hair. If we were going to put this against a light background, we wouldn't have to worry about that. So don't do more work than you need to do. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my videos. So right now there's two modes. There's color aware and object aware. So color aware works the best when we have a simple background. Object aware works best when we're using a complex background. So right now we're working on a simple background. The reason for that is this is a tutorial. I want to clearly show you what the tools do, and it's easiest to see against a simple background. This is not a review to see how well this feature works, and this is not a challenge for me to see how good I am at cutting out images. This is a tutorial for people to understand what each of these sliders and each of these tools do. Now, let me just quickly go into the black and white for a sec. So this tool knows that these areas in white are the areas we're going to keep, the areas in black are the areas we're going to throw away. Where all these tools work and where all the decisions are made is on the edges. And that's the purpose of this, is to get nice, clean, crisp edges, no matter what type of image we're working on. So let's turn on Show Edge so we can view the edge and see what's going on. So we'd have to put something in here to show you the edge. So that's the selection edge. Now, this edge is where Photoshop detects what should be on the inside and what should be on the outside. This is the decision zone. Now, let me change this to on black so we can start to see some of the colors. If I was to increase this radius, you can start to see the edge of the photograph. Now, here's the thing. Where we have hard edges, such as the edges of her arms and flesh, we want to have a very small selection, and that'll give us a nice crisp edge. Where we have soft areas such as hair and fur, we want a larger edge so it encompasses this area and enables the algorithm to sort out what should be there and what shouldn't be there. Now, one edge does not fit all. When we look on this image, you can see the hair is different than the body. Maybe the dress might fit in with some of the hair because that has a softer edge. One tip, you don't have to do everything in one selection. Sometimes you can go into one refinement, do it for the soft areas, do a second refinement, do it for the hard areas, mask them together, and I'll show that later. So in order to get a clean selection, you want to have as thin an edge as possible. So I'm going to drop this radius down to 1. And we're going to turn the show edge off. That edge is there even though you can't see it right now. So what we want is we want a wider edge around the hair. So if I grab this tool here, the refine tool, which is turned on by default, and I start to paint it around the edges of the hair, notice it starts to pick up bits of hair that were getting missed out before. Maybe I'll put this on white so you can see better. Notice up here, see how we start to get some of those edges of that hair. Now, if we look on show edge, notice what's happened. As we've painted around the hair, we probably would want to go that way too, we're expanding in that area. Okay, let me undo this because I'm going to show you a quicker way we can do that. So we know now we want to paint around that hair. So you'll see an option that says refine hair. Turn that on and that will do it for you. So let's turn the edge back off and we can see the edge of the hair has been selected. Now I can still refine it by using the refine tool. And in fact, I would use this refine tool. Let's make it a little smaller, left bracket key. We would run it around the edge of the dress. Look at this. And now we get that softer edge back again. See how that just blends in. And if we look at the show edge, that's because we're expanding it around there and are allowing those little fairy edges to show through. And sometimes you can view it like this. Let's turn that edge off. If we want to view it on black, see how now we've got those soft edges. And if you want to compare this with the original selection, just choose show original. And we can see this is what it used to look like. And here it is after the adjustments we've made. And we have more settings over here under the global refinements. You can click on there to open them. So here's the thing, if you don't need to make any adjustments on these tools, don't. So for many cases, what we've already done is going to give us a good result. So if we zoom in here, we can see maybe that arm is not quite as good as we wanted. So there's other tools that we can use to kind of clean this up. And these are going to be under the refinements. So when we have an edge like this, I like to call it the smudgies, where some of it's there and some of it isn't. Let's have a look on the mask and see what we've got going on. We can see there's a gray edge there. What we want is a solid edge, not that gray edge. And we can actually fix that by increasing contrast. See how that contrast will push those gray areas and make them solid. Let's look at it on the image. Increasing that contrast, see how that pushes those and gets rid of those gray areas. However, when we do that, notice we've got a little bit of jaggies. The jaggies are those rough edges. Now we can fix those by using smooth. So if I increase the smooth, notice how we can smoothen that up. And that will definitely fix those issues. However, when we start to use these tools on areas like hair, now we're starting to get helmet hair. Let me show you. Turn the smooth off. So notice that the smooth is affecting the hair. So is the contrast. When we increase that contrast, we also increase it in the hair, which can result in helmet hair. So what do? I just want to preface, for a lot of cases, this selection is going to be good enough. But if we want to go further, what we want to do is we want to save this selection that we've done for the soft areas and create a second selection for the hard areas. So the way we're going to do this, I'm just going to take the output and I'm going to create a new layer with a layer mask and click OK. And we're going to call this soft. So now we've got a good selection and a good refinement for her skirt and her hair. But it's not perfect on things like her arms. Once again, this is good enough for many situations. But let me show you what we would do. Let's hide that layer, go back into the background layer again. We're going to choose select subject one more time. Now we go back into select a mask. This time we don't care about the hair and the skirt. We already got that. Let's just focus on this arm. Okay, so we got some jaggies here. Let's have a look at those on the black and white. Okay, so this time we're going in here and notice we don't have as many problems with the jaggies as we had before. And the reason for that is we haven't made alterations to this mask to help with the hair and the skirt. So it's actually looking pretty good now. There is a little adjustment we could make though. We could increase the smoothness just a little bit. And see how that just nicely smoothens those edges. And we can give it a little bit of contrast. So it's looking good. There's a little aliasing there and sometimes a little touch of feather can fix that. So this would actually give us a pretty good edge. Now we're going to look at these tools in a second by themselves, but right now we're going to output this to a new layer with a layer mask. And we're going to call this one hard. Okay, so we've got the two different layers. The bottom one here has the best on the skin on the arm here, and the top one has the best for the hair and the soft edges. So we want to use the best of both. Now the challenge is if I go in and I start trying to change the masks, we're going to lose our edges. So here's a tip. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take the top one and I'm going to hit Control or Command G for group. This puts it into a group and this enables me to apply a new mask. So now I can mask this layer without affecting the original mask. So what I want to do is I just want to hide that part of the arm on the soft layer. So I'm going to grab a brush. Make sure we've got black for the foreground because black hides. And we'll use a soft edge brush. And that will just blend in a little bit nicer. And I'm just going to paint away that edge. That's all we've got to do. Now, let's do the bottom part. Now, if I turn this on, this shows it everywhere. And notice it affects the hair. So what we're going to do is we're going to put this in a group as well. Control G. Or Command G gives us a group. And so now we've got the hard edge in its own group and we can apply its own mask. But this time I'm going to hold down the Alt or the Option key when I apply that mask and this hides it. So all I want to do is I just want to show that edge around here. Notice it's already masked, so I just want to reveal it. So I'm going to grab that mask. So I'm just going to grab white for the foreground color. And just paint around this edge and bring in the nice edge. So now we're able to merge both of the mask cutouts to get the best of both worlds. So there's one other thing I want to show you when it's working with hair and fur, and then I'm going to do an additional tutorial where we look at these other adjustments on hard edges. So here's a picture of a lion, and we're going to grab our object selection tool. And we're going to use Select Subject. Use Cloud for better quality and choose Select Subject. Now we want to choose Select a Mask. Notice we've got the fur all the way around. So rather than choosing the Refine tool, let's just click on the Refine tool and that will open up the option for Refine Hair. And we're going to click on that. And notice that does a much better job of the fur. Now notice we've got dark edges around here. We can fix these by using decontaminate colors. Watch what happens when I click decontaminate colors. Notice that we get beautiful color here now instead of those black edges. Now it's a little aggressive and we're starting to lose some detail around the top here. We're losing some hairs. So this is where we can use the amount and dial it back a little bit. Then we can blend decontaminate colors and get the best possible result. Now remember, you don't have to use all of these tools in every image. In fact, you should use the minimum amount that you need to get the result that you need. So that's part one of two. I hope you learned something new. If you did, drop a comment underneath and let us know. Now the second part is going to dive into the rest of the tools, including all the global refinements, where I'm going to show you what each tool does and exactly how it works and where to use it. So I'll link to that right here. If you're watching this the day it came out, it's coming in a couple of days. So anyway, if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.